Hello, duckies, and welcome back to Alone in the Dark. My name's Viola. If you like what you see, hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. It really does help the channel. So we just finished up with the... Okay, I still don't have access to the attic. But we just finished up with the Dark Man's Temple. We found the contract.
To be around here somewhere. He wouldn't leave this house.
I don't know what to think anymore. You run into that detective fella?
Who is he? Can he be trusted?
I think he one of the good guys. Well, you know, like us.
Will he be all right with her coming? Praise the mother.
He don't need to know about all that. Just calm down. It ain't time yet.
God. Hurts.
As far as I can tell, Detective Carnby seems to be solving problems, not causing.
Just be ready in case he starts anything.
Round real quick. Because last time I didn't look around, I ended up missing something entirely. Okay. So dining room. Library. It's getting worse. Right.
Christ, what the hell was that?
We must have faith that Jeremy's... Lunas.
Sure why that might help. Huh. Now it's locked. Heck. Hmm.
must be a spare key to Dr. Gray's office. I need the key. I don't have the combination for this. Maybe Jeremy did.
One or something like that.
It worked.
The last...
Dr. Gray's office, all to myself. Let's see if we can figure this guy out.
I'm gonna unlock...
I have finished tidying.
This is where McCarthy has hidden my favorite young. It's very important.
This is arrow key.
Dearest Dr. Man.
Anything else in here that I need to get? Does not look like it. Okay.
This can't be real.
Okay, then.
Dr. Gray was somehow mixed up in this business with the dark man, Detective Carnby decided. He had to be. Either Dr. Gray was using the idea of the dark man to manipulate and torture Jeremy, or the dark man was an actual powerful being possessing Jeremy. And in that case, Dr. Gray was simply a stooge. Maybe both could be true at once. Carnby felt his mind racing in all directions. No matter what, he had to find a way to break the pact. That was what Jeremy said was needed. It didn't even matter what was true or not. If Jeremy wouldn't leave Derceto before the contract was broken, then Carnby had to make it happen. He just wished the steps on the contract made a little more sense.
Detective Carnby, good to see you again. Solved your case yet?
I'm trying. Hey, Grace, you okay?
Oh, she is just peachy, Detective. Are you looking forward to the Feast of St. John, Grace?
I can't wait.
Kids, ain't they great?
What exactly are you planning for tonight?
Oh, not much. We eat, we drink. Pay tribute to the wishing tree in the conservatory. The usual.
Then why all the excitement?
There is just something about tonight. Something's different. I think we all feel it. Besides, we got ourselves some new words for the prayer thanks to your buddy Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out, and things will begin again.
That sounds strangely threatening.
You should come.
Oh, God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
Better hold on to these. Wouldn't want them to get lost. There's something missing.
It's always useful. Yeah, where did I touch it? I don't like Jack in the Boxes.
Jeremy knew.
Something to do with Grace's. Maybe it's in McAfee's room. Honestly, the way he's reacting, it's almost like...
Surprisingly, Pete. Maybe I've been selling that old barfly short. Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside.
Sometimes, I think this place makes me worse. That Derceto might be my grave. A coffin made of ostentatious architecture. A Taj Mahal for the drunken depressed. There's something about Derceto. Something about Dr. Gray. Like we all pretend that we're here to get better. When in fact, we are here to be forgotten.
Doesn't that just sound lovely? Okay, so I don't know how to get that out yet. I don't have a tool or anything to pull that out at any point. What about Grace's missing? Fine, I'll go in the final room. Not yet. Or not, because apparently I gotta go this way.
I can't take this much more. This has to end.
Thank you. I can't go into the empty room until after I go down the stairs.
Radio. Hypothetical.
Yay, I don't have the key. Oh boy.
And we're back here. Well, perfect time to have a look around this place.
Not yet. Gotta backtrack. I didn't get to go and look at the empty room. What? Which number is it?
I know that number. Where's that from? I did this.
Okay. That's the last three numbers. Two, got it, okay.
Detective, I have made many discoveries in my case. The child we want is safe, thanks to good people like me and you. We're so similar, but you don't see all the things I do. To find your man, Jeremy, you also need to look for the girl. It has always been that way. The young deliver us all. You should have a look in my room. There's a piece of the puzzle you will need. Take care now. My coffee.
How
form.
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Why would McCarthy lock this up? Was he trying to keep Grace from completing the shape? If so, couldn't she have just made another drawing?
Oh. Lovely.
What the hell happened in here?
I Carnby side. Husband has returned to steal one of our most valuable paintings. I'm sure he needs to sell it. If you hurry, I'm sure you can track him down.
Isn't it? How long had it been since I drowned myself in drink and depression? It all felt so peaceful, slipping away into oblivion. The welcoming voice wrapped around my mind like a heavy blanket. It turned off suddenly as I woke up from the sound of my office door closing shut. A messenger had left a telegram for Mrs. Saunders. She had a lead on where to find her husband and her kidnapped daughter. God, I used to drink so much back then. Kid got taken by her father, headed out of state, but he had made a mistake by selling a painting that his wife actually cared about to a collector named Thornhill to fund his venture. That's how I tracked him down. At least I think so.
Thank you.
case can't be squeaky clean.
Is leading us forward, kind of idea.
Mr. Saunders had sold a valuable painting to Thornhill, hoping the money would carry him to wherever he was going. The painting, now leaning on an easel in Thornhill's bedroom, had a certain mesmerizing gloom that seemed to call out to me, telling me I was needed for something important. I felt myself falling into the painting, only being brought back by Thornhill, thrusting an address to a Hotel St. George into my hand, and asking me to get the hell out. I don't remember this at all, but I can't say it didn't happen. Oh. I just realized what I'm probably going to have to face. Somewhere in here. Because I haven't had to deal with it again. Thank you.
don't like the thought of it. The big dude. Big dude who's all rude. Rudy toody dude. The bells, Esmeralda. String's leading this way. That means that's the way to go. Okay. I want to go back this way really quick and see if there's anything more over here.
Go that way.
Yeah, I figured I can't go that way. Just to make sure we were all on the same page. And we all had the same stuff. Behind me. Can't make me ring that bell. Yes, I will beat someone up with a candlestick. So that's the way it works. Maybe it will enlighten them about something. Is this where it's gonna happen? Oh yeah, I see you. I see you, String. I don't trust you. Although I should, there's no reason the yarn has not betrayed me. At least not purposefully. Yet. Seriously, I did this? Ugh.
On my way to the hotel, the Morton gang caught up with me. I owed them money. A lot of it. I can't remember what for. Probably some dumb gambling debt growing in size for each payment missed. I punched one of them out, and I sent the others packing.
Oh God. Thank you.
Life is a stage play performed to no one, applauded by no one, and wanted by no one. A story already written, meant to play out in one way only. I wrote my book in order to explain that there might be more to life. That free will isn't truly free unless it moves against the expected. In retrospect, I think my ambition was hubristic. Yermi had a much more humble suggestion. What if we all just went home?
That always sounds nice.
Catch up with them here. I must have followed them. But where? That's right, he was running away, ditching his old life and marriage in New Orleans to find something better in Tallahassee. And he took his daughter with him against the will of the mother. That's why she hired me. But I stopped him. I caught up with him at the Pearl River Bridge. Pearl River. This is where I caught up with them. This is what the Dark Man wanted me to revisit. But I'm still not seeing it. What am I forgetting?
Obviously, it wants me to go down and get into this boat. Because that's where the string's leading. There's a side pass. And I want to check it out. Just in case the side path leads me to trouble. Let's be honest, that's more likely than not. This is a long side path. Where is it taking me? Trying to see over there if I'm not that. Let's try this way.
Edward had heard the whispers for years. When he lived in Brooklyn, it was only on rare occasions, like when he as a child climbed that tall tree in Central Park, or when he almost drowned in the Hudson River, trying to save his despaired mother. The whispers became more common as he moved to New Orleans, but still rare enough to be ignored. Now as he walks the halls of Derceto, he knows what is calling him. He doesn't want to admit it. But the dark young in the conservatory is telling him to sacrifice the cabris and corn.
Oh God! Okay, well, that happened. Scared the daylights out of me, but it happened. Okay, you know what? Let's check this bridge now. Might be a bad idea.
Oh no. It was her all along. I can't believe I didn't recognize you.
I looked a little different back then, I suppose.
Was any of this real?
How do you mean?
This day, just so much is happening. I can't. I think I've lost my head. Do you need me to apologize? I mean, I am sorry. I don't think I can even begin to explain. You're just a kid, Grace. I'm really sorry. I didn't mean for it to happen.
Lies. More lies.
No, really. I thought I was being a good guy by handing you over to your mother. I didn't know. I couldn't have known that she wouldn't care about you.
I don't know how this works. What is this for?
Some form of admission of guilt. Maybe acceptance. It's what the Dark Man wants.
I guess we just watch my father die again, then.
You think he's alive?
I know he is. He's down there, scared that he won't be able to get out. That he will drown with his daughter again.
What are you saying? We gotta save him!
We? Do it yourself. I'm down there with him, remember?
Can I really save them? This all happened so long ago. I have to find a way to get down there. I have to see it with my own eyes.
I think I wanna go
there was
back
a boat at
see.
The house where I entered. If I can raise the bridge, I should be able to get to the car.
Leading to the boat. I need the boat. How do I get in the boat? I need to boat. Please, let me boat. Unless it wasn't talking about this boat. It's talking about another? Maybe there's one farther along? I don't think it was talking about this. Please. Getting distracted. I don't need to be distracted. Do I? Do I need to be distracted? Hello, crows. How are you today, crows?
This must be where the bridge is operating. Nothing's happening. It's like something's holding it back.
Oh, lovely. You again. You guys want to come at me? Come at me. Come at me. Yeah, you're super weak. Get out of here. Let go. Does everything let go? So does that mean that I can get down somewhere? Wasting ammo at this point, I think. Bother. You guys. Like Emily was there.
Carnby. Are you okay?
Don't leave me alone.
What the hell have you been doing?
What's going on here? Look at this mess!
I'm sorry, Mrs. Thompson.
Don't make me kick you out of this house! Now get out!
Hey, Detective. Mr. Carnby. I'm really worried about you.
I'm okay. I just need to catch my breath for a moment.
This place? It's... There are some very disturbed figures around here. And I don't think it's just the patients. I've been reading some things about how Derceto has a deranging effect on people. I think it might explain... things.
What?
Just take it easy, okay? I'm gonna go find a way into Dr. Gray's apartment. I wanna know what he's hiding.
Emily? Don't worry. I think I'm close. I'm gonna set everything right.
Just be careful.
Okay, so I probably should have explored a bit more, but that's going to be it for today's episode, so thank you all for watching. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell icon to keep up to date on all the videos, and remember to free the feral wildflower in you. Bye-bye!